Your past is his past now. He's going to be your phantom.
This is you, as you've lived until this day. Tomorrow, it becomes a phantom.
Not some simple diversion. He'll act as the new big boss. He'll be your face on the world stage until the time comes for your resurgence. His altered state of consciousness has helped us implant powerful suggestions through induced hypnagogia. He's experienced all your missions on record and shares all your knowledge and experience to make him believe that he is the one true big boss.
I'm big boss, and you are too. I have to drive out this demon inside me. Build a better future.
V has come too.
In 1984, in the British hospital in Dekelia, Cyprus, we at the player are awakened from the disastrous events that took place during Ground Zeroes. We awaken highly confused and unsure what is happening around us. We only know what the doctor has told us, that we don't have long and there is people after us and we must change our identity. The Phantom Pain is one of revenge in its story, but it goes much more deeper than that, as we come to realize that it's more to do with identity and dissociation from the character and us as the player, to an intentional distorted reality, where one is questioning as if they're playing as the legendary hero, whilst in reality, behind the visage, it is us, the player, who are in the hospital bed. We ourselves, Venom Snake, are experiencing this dissociation from oneself. MGS5 blatantly betrays his message as the doctor shows us an appearance of what appears to be Big Boss, but in the second scenes shows a completely different character, where this was our dissociation from actually on who we was, and staring back at us in the mirror was our actual true reflection. The poetic beauty of this scene was to demonstrate how one was transitioning into becoming us as the individual, into becoming the legend. On our awakening, we're greeted by the song, The Man Who Sold the World. The placement of said song was put there intentionally, for us the player to decipher. And just like Venom Snake when he comes to realize who his true identity is, it took time for us as the player to figure out the deeper meaning behind the song, where even at the end of the game it left us scratching our heads. So let's do a breakdown of the song and see how we can put the pieces of the lyrics into the scenes. At the start of the song, it says, "We passed upon the stair, when we spoke of wasn't when, although I wasn't there, he said I was his friend." Now this is referring to Ishmael, as Ishmael is a conception within Venom Snake and the player's mind. Some people would question as if this was actually Big Boss, but in reality, we was actually talking to ourselves, a concept of the person who helped us escape the hospital.
Who am I? You're talking to yourself. Been watching over you for 9 years. You can call me Ishmael.
Ishmael is a projection from our mind. One that we can put an interpretation to. Respectfully, one can see how it would be Big Boss. This moment is of interpretation, as we can't exactly know the identity behind the person wearing the bandages. But assuming that we are Big Boss, there possibly can't be a second one, or at least that was the thought at the time. But if we look deeper into the critically acclaimed David Bowie's The Man Who Sold the World, we can see that it is also to do with dissociation of oneself, such as personality disorders and schizophrenia. The shrapnel in Venom Snake's head causes a lot of his hallucinations that we see in the game. So what we, the player, and Venom see may not be true. It's only as true as what our mind is telling us.
Your skull is pressing on your optic nerve. I'm told any hard impact could have an effect on your visual cortex.
Yeah, the doctor mentioned that.
Your brain might process visual information incorrectly. In other words, you could have hallucinations. You might see things that aren't there, or not see things as they really are.
Metal Gear Solid 5 was smart how it was trying to subtly let us know that we wasn't playing as the real Big Boss. But our refusal, as we was in denial of our dissociation that we was in, to honestly believe we can't be playing as anyone else other than Big Boss. The perfect example of this is when we extract the Russian interpreter. For anyone who's played the previous Metal Gear games, we're aware that Big Boss speaks Russian.
By the way, your Russian is superb. Where did you learn to speak it?
From my mentor.
Throughout the game, Venom Snake is experiencing this dissociation and somewhat of a PTSD and guilt. Throughout the entirety of The Phantom Pain, we're trying to pick up the pieces, to put together a distorted reality that is not of our own, but instead we are the Phantom, continuing a legacy of another person, of a past memory that is embedded into our minds. The beauty of Hideo Kojima's work is trying to represent the fact that us as the player are Venom Snake. Through the entirety of The Phantom Pain, we have been sold out by the man who sold the world, fulfilling a legacy that is not ours, convinced by our most loyal companion that we are the very said person. Within Venom's broken mind, he is convinced that Paz is still alive, but in reality, she died a long time ago, and she's just a concept inside his mind. And me as the player at the time was convinced the same, that she was alive.
Do you get it now? You do, don't you? Peace Day. Never came.
Paz's tape is a construction in Venom's mind. There is no Paz's tape, as Paz had died and had long well passed away. There couldn't possibly be a tape left behind. It's Snape's subconscious from his guilt and his dissociation from him not being able to let go of his phantoms. A past that is seemingly haunting and is playing into his mental health along with his subconscious feelings.
Our wishes do not come true. We just cling on to our dreams, our phantoms, mine and yours. There's more to remember than hatred and rage. But of course, this is you thinking that I should think that. It is no mystery now. I am just a phantom, a fragment of the mind you have lost. The real me died a long time ago.
Which brings me to the next lyrics within the song. The lyrics saying, which came as some surprise, I spoke into his eyes, I thought you died a long, long time ago. Very interestingly, you can see how the music mirrors also the scenes. As when you first start the missions with Paz, Snake is very surprised at the revelation that Paz is still alive, assuming she died all that time ago.
Paz.
That's right. It's her.
What about the bomb?
We were able to remove the explosives. Both of them.
The dissociation is quite evident, with Snake having an identity crisis on trying to figure out the past along with himself. Coming to realize this in this scene, as we can see the butterfly that appears to land, and as when Snake tries to grab hold of it, it appears to disappear in thin air. Symbolically speaking, the butterfly is known in symbolism as being a part of your transformation. Transformation is clearly evident within Phantom Pain, as Venom himself is having a tough time getting into adjusted into this transformation to him to play his new part as Big Boss. MGS5 is definitely profound, and unlike most movies and games, it has a special quality that, unlike any other Metal Gear game, we can hold dearly to our hearts. It has something different, and something unique, and something very profound that we still try to figure out and put pieces together. And throughout any other Metal Gear game in the franchise, MGS5 has definitely been the most analyzed. The interpretation of this moment when Snake grabs the butterfly and it disappears is one to believe that he's trying to hold on to this transformation and change.
Still standing motionless.
Venom Snake is tied between two personalities, that of his original self and that of Big Boss. It's a confliction between two personalities, with one trying to fight with the other, as between Snake's determining of what's right and what's wrong. That's one of the biggest giveaways within the game to why Venom Snake himself was really nothing like Big Boss. If you were to examine both of their personalities, they were very different in their own ways. He really took a scientific approach on Venom Snake's mental health, making all what he did on his mission all the more impressive. So fantastically intriguing is how we all had this dissociative identity disorder, even though none of us may suffer from mental illness. This game did it so well that us ourselves was dissociative in our own way, as we was to partake and carry out the duty of Big Boss. To get a clearer understanding of it, I think it's worth taking a look at this clip.
Dissociative identity disorder is when an individual develops alternate personalities that function with or without the awareness of the person's usual self. The Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders, also known as DSM-5, identifies it as an identity disruption indicated by the presence of two or more distinct personality states. DID is one of a group of conditions called dissociative disorders. Dissociative disorders are mental illnesses that involve disruptions or breakdowns of behavior, consciousness, memory and perception, cognition, or sensory motor functioning, which would otherwise function normally. When one or more of these functions is disrupted, dissociative symptoms can result.
We're really looking at the root inspiration behind the masterpiece, The Man Who Sold the World. Then we have to look at David Bowie and find out the interest behind what it is that he made this song for. And for why Hideo Kojima took such inspiration to place in Metal Gear Solid 5. David Bowie is a very creative genius. He doesn't seem to take things as they are and likes to look in between the lines and see the inner deeper meaning behind such things. Hence why his artwork and his musician creativity was so different, unlike any other artist, with his stylish different ways of presentation. If you read the quotation, it is amazingly how much it mirrors the likes of Metal Gear Solid 5's story. It fits just like a piece of a jigsaw puzzle. As the report says, the meaning of the song The Man Who Sold the World by David Bowie, the loss of identity and the search for oneself. Bowie wrote the song as a reflection of his own feelings of the alienation, dissatisfaction with fame, which he felt had sold him out. He also wrote it as an expression for his quest for finding the part of himself that he was missing. The song is the dialogue between Bowie and his alter ego, The Man Who Sold the World. Fascinatingly, everything that Bowie has described about such song is everything that almost seems to be in mirror comparison with Metal Gear Solid 5. Of course, when it talks about alienation and Ocelot being the alienator, both Venom and you as the viewer.
My name's Ocelot. Big boss. You know who I am. A certain man gave me a job to do. Two, actually. The first was to get you out of that hospital. The second was to rescue the man himself.
At the end of Metal Gear Solid 5, we see the lies within the truth. Us as the viewer and Venom Snake have been sold out by our own beloved soldier, Big Boss, along with Zero, Cypher, who staged this plan to begin with, by deceiving the world, or for a better quote, selling the world. Selling the world into a fabricated lie in order for Big Boss to continue his mission to change the world for how he intended for the boss's will to be, with us being in the firing line, being put on the world stage, and taking the fame and glory of Big Boss, along with the dangers that it brings with it. Being alienated and shaped into a different character made by others for their expectations of us to be. For us becoming Big Boss, we embody everything that the legend has made. It's at this point, poetically speaking, we and Venom realize our true identity, as we have now put the pieces together from all that we've experienced to realize that something is not as it seems. And staring back at us at the mirror is very similar to what we remember from before, but it's not quite right as it does not live up to who it is we remember from the person we're staring back at us in the mirror. Finally get the confirmation we need as Big Boss finally leaves us the last message to let us know that he is happy with us to continue his name on the world stage to be Big Boss. True reflection behind the alter ego appears.
Now do you remember who you are? What you were meant to do?
I cheated death thanks to you. And thanks to you, I've left my mark. You have to. You've written your own history. You're your own man. I'm Big Boss. And you are too.
The interpretation of the mirror scene, one can come to many conclusions. Is Venom Snake happy with the outcome of the happenings of being Big Boss? Or does he feel a sense of betrayal and hatred? To read the body language of Venom Snake, we as the player had to come to this conclusion to decide what it is that Venom's intentions were. How did Venom feel along with us as the player? By reading his facial expressions, one can come to their own interpretation for what it is he was thinking at that time. Could just be that Venom was happy with taking on the role of Big Boss and the merit that it carries. Or perhaps he maybe hated what it was, but realized the mission that he had to carry out and fulfill, and perhaps had his old goals and his own agendas to carry. Much can be said as Snake approaches the mirror and in the reflection appears to be something of a demon. Could be something personal between Venom and his own inner feelings, for what this demon is within is why he punches the mirror. Or it could just be that he hates the idea of being Big Boss. Reflection in the mirror reminds him of the betrayal at the hands of those who need him to carry out the boss's will. In turn, despising what he sees in the mirror, which is Big Boss. Whatever it is, it's left for our interpretation, just as Hideo Kojima intended for us to decide on what it is, how we feel. As the viewer received the title of Big Boss. But the question is, who sold the world? The answer lies in the reflection of the mirror, who is staring back at you. This has been The Voice Box. Thank you for your time, and I'd appreciate it if you could like and subscribe, and leave me a comment in the section down below.